What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 22 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Brilliant Diamond. Last time, we defeated the Veilstone Gym, we beat Maylene and got the Cobble Badge, but at the end, we found out that Dawn had her Pokedex stolen by Team Galactic, and now we gotta go rescue her. But first, I wanna do a quick update on my guys here. Let's get Crobat in. I think I'm going to switch out Gyarados with Shinx, and I think I'll pull Graveler out as well. What I want to do is actually bring Badoo back. I'm not sure how much more I have to go to get it to evolve, but I know I got to evolve it during the daytime hours, which honestly for me has been a bit of a struggle to find the time to record during the day. I swear, I think I still have some drift on my controller here. But anyway, I know there's still a few other buildings here in Veilstone that I want to check out, but business first. I'm going to lead off with Crobat, and let's go ahead and find Dawn. She's right here, as a matter of fact. You're trying to get the Pokedex back from us? Not when we, Team Galactic, can make so much better use of it. But okay, guarding the warehouse does get boring. We'll take you on 2-on-2. What, now you brought your buddy along so you can get your Pokedex back? Well, we're just as happy to send you both of you crying home to your mommies. Hi, T.U.G. Can you help me? I dropped my Pokedex by accident and Team Galactic found it. Now they won't give it back. Please, I need your help. Team up and battle with me. You bet. You and your Pokemon together with me and my Pokemon? United at this, our dream team has no chance of losing. I'm not letting Team Galactic get away with this. And we're going to have ourselves a little 2-on-2 battle here. They're going to send out Beautifly and Dustox to start things off. Good thing I started with Crobat. I believe I can use Pluck on these guys. Let's start with Dustox here. Not quite enough to take it down, though. Going to attack us with Air Cutter, which can actually hit both targets. I'm going to try Venus Shot. That could really hurt Clefairy. Luckily, Clefairy's pretty bulky. Now she's going to attack with Disarming Voice. Nice. Was that enough to take out Dustox? No. So what I'll do is I'll pluck Beautifly. Clip your wings. And Beautifly goes down. We're going to get some experience for that. Badoo levels up. Good. I think Badoo needs to gain some levels anyway. And there goes the Venus Shock. And she'll use Disarming Voice to take down Dustox. And I just had 4 Pokemon level up. Crobat, Luxio, Monferno, and Machop. Crobat wants to learn Air Cutter? Okay. You know what? Air Cutter is a special move. High chance for critical hit. My special attack's slightly better. I'm going to get rid of Absorb. I don't think we really have a need for that anymore. So now Crobat has 2 flying attacks and 2 poison attacks. I honestly think Monferno could evolve at any moment now. Now they're going to start off with Krogunk, and who else is joining? Stunky. Alright. I think what I'll do is I'll hit Air Cutter and hit both targets. Puts Krogunk down with 1 shot, nice. That's that high critical of that move kicking in there. And Badoo levels up again, wow. I'm glad it's getting a little bit of a recognition there. Another Disarming Voice. Not going to be enough to take it down, but I should be able to finish it off. I'll just use Pluck. Got him. And that is that. Now give Dawn's Pokedex back. Done it by 2 kids? This isn't right. I should have kept my head down and just washed our warehouse. We got 2,600 for winning. Aw, that stinks. Our Pokemon are weak. We should get new ones from headquarters. Who cares about some Pokedex anyways? Team Galactic is going to own all the Pokemon in the world. No, in the universe. There, take it. Take your Pokedex. Those things we had in the warehouse have already moved to Pistoria City anyway. So we'll say you'll get yours and run like the grunts we are. What's going on? Why is Team Galactic out in the streets like they own the place? T.U.G, thank you sincerely. If Professor Rowan's ever find out that I lost my Pokedex, I don't want to think about it. So T.U.G, what are you going to do now? I'm thinking of going to Pistoria City. Great Marsh there is home to many kinds of Pokemon. So, sounds like Pistoria City will be our next port of call, but before we start trekking there, let's head in here. Go ahead and grab this item. It's TM94 Fly. And I think I know exactly who I'm going to teach that to. Fly and the hidden moves app allows you to travel instantly to towns you've visited before, and because we have the Cobble Badge now, we can use Fly outside of battle. So, I bet you already know who I'm going to give it to. Yeah, it's going to be Crobat. I'm going to keep Air Cutter and get rid of Pluck. So, I'm just going to get rid of Pluck. Alright, that was my only one. But I do believe that I don't necessarily need to know Fly to actually use it. So I've also got Drain Punch, which none of my guys can learn. Nasty Plot. I'll hold on to those for now. Okay. And also, there's a couple of buildings that we passed up in our previously. And it's down here. I think this is where you can actually change your outfits. Metronome Style Shop. Your dream style anytime. Let's go in and have a look. Talk to these people. Welcome. At Metronome Style Shop, you can choose a new outfit to achieve your perfect look. I'm so shocked, the t-shirts with the Clefairy pattern are sold out. I'm not sure what to buy. Well, let's see what's for sale and how much they cost. We have the Pikachu hoodie style. Seems okay. Overall style. No. Looks too, too redneck or something. The Eevee jacket style. The Gengar jacket style. Kind of like the purple. Cyber style. I love the black and green, but that seems to be a little much for me. Maybe some other time. But yeah, it's $45,000. I kind of want to look at the department store later, so. Winter style. Spring style. Casual style. And really, that's really casual. Then leather jacket style, which I think is a little much. That's $120,000. No. But you know, I think I actually got a style from my mystery gifts. That's platinum style, which is essentially the clothes I wore in Pokemon Platinum. I had a slightly different outfit there, and I think it looks better on me, to be honest with you. So I'm going to stick with that. So anyways, last stop is going to be the department store. And I've been wanting to check this place out. Actually, this is not the department store, but you know what? I might as well have a look around inside. The Team Galactic Credo. Everything belongs to Team Galactic. Look beyond the world. Space will become Team Galactic's. I can't really do anything about it now. That warp tile apparently does not work. Suppose we can talk to some people here. Welcome, this is Team Galactic headquarters. I'm sorry, this is the Galactic Veilstone building. Cosmic energy for the win. Wouldn't it be wonderful if we could harness that balanced energy? We, Team Galactic, will take everything that can be taken. We will eliminate everything that is not needed. That is Team Galactic's policy. Team Galactic conducts research around the clock here. We focus on the development of new energy resources. Why, are you going to travel to space or something? Try and take over the universe? You're too young for us. You can join us when you're older. Don't worry, I had no intention of joining you guys. Is there anything up here? No. I guess not. Okay. Alright, let's head to the department store now while I have a look at it. And here we go. Discover a new you, Veilstone Department Store. Welcome to the fabulous Veilstone Department Store. So let's see what you guys have. Oh, they sell super potions and they sell hyper potions. And revive, so I'm gonna go ahead and just grab a couple of these. And I will also grab a few of these. Alright. And I think I have some stuff I want to get rid of here. Anything I don't need. Get rid of these. I'm never going to use them. Berries, let's see. Get rid of the PP up. I'm not going to use that. All these TMs I'm going to hold on to. Wow, hold on to that. I can't sell those. Okay, so heading back up now. Let me close that Pokedex here. We're giving away a Pokedex app as for free as a promotion. I give you the counter app over the counter. Would you like it? Sure. All it does is count. That's all it does. The counter app can be used to count to 9,999. Here, I'll demonstrate it real quick. That's essentially all it does. So if I want to count, can I, that's really all I can do. Alright, so let's see what else these guys have for sale. Oh, that's the vitamins. I'm not going to worry about that right now. You have the X items, which I have no need for. Thank you. It's tracking all my steps. No thanks. I think those guys on the right just recommend certain items for you. I'm not going to worry about them. But we've got TMs here, so let's see what we got. Fire Blast, Thunder, Blizzard, Focus Blast, Flamethrower. I think I'll grab one of these. Thunderbolt, I'll definitely grab one of these. Ice Beam, wouldn't hurt to have an ice attack. I'll grab one of these. Solar Beam, I'll hold off on. Psychic, I definitely want. I think I'm going to get two of them. Dazzling Gleam. It wouldn't hurt to have a Fairy-type move, so I'll grab that. TM-74's Gyro Ball. Steel move. I really have no need for it right now. Giga Impact and Hyper Beam are honestly a little too strong for my taste right now. And let's see what you have. You have more. Low Sweep, Bulldoze. I'll grab one of these. I'll grab a U-turn as well for having a bug move. Let's see, False Swipe. I could keep that in case I need to set up a Pokemon for catching Pokemon. Rest, Protect, Safeguard, Reflect, Light Screen, Substitute, Endure, Work Up, Sword Stance, Double Team, Flash. I actually do have TM-70 for Flash. I do want to teach that to one of my Pokemon. I'm going to take a Swords Dance. And I'm going to take a Double Team. Actually, you know what? I'll take one more Double Team. Alright. So, before I move up, let's go ahead and teach my guys some new moves here. I have all these new TMs. Okay, Flamethrower. Both I was surprised that Machop can actually learn Flamethrower, but I want it to go to Monferno. I think I'm gonna get rid of Power Up Punch. Okay. Now I got Thunderbolt. Definitely want to give that to Luxio. Whoops. Picked the wrong Pokemon. Let's get rid of Tackle. No one can learn Ice Beam yet. I'll hold on to that. Psychic. I want to give that to Kadabra. Dazzling Gleam. I can give it to Badoo, so I think I'll go ahead and do that. Just so we have a fairy move in the arsenal. I'll get rid of Growth. Bulldoze. I don't think I really need that for him. And then U-turn. You know, that could work for Crobat, I think. Be nice to have a little bit of variety here. I'll get rid of Poison Fang. And take U-turn instead. That way it has a little bit of a chance against psychic types. False Swipe, no one can learn. Swords Dance. And Double Team, I'll hold on to for now. Alright, let's see what more we have up here. Okay, looks like we have Pedestals. I really don't have a need for them right now. And more Pedestals. Don't really need those right now. Yeah, it just tells you what the hot items are. And what's on the fifth floor here? This looks like a little rec area. I've had enough of shopping for a while. I'll grab a drink and unwind a bit. Now we can get a vending machine here. Get our freshly squeezed lemonade. Only buy them one at a time, though. Grab a few cans here. Lemonades, I think, are the best bang for the buck, I believe. Alright, and nobody else here. I've shopped here loyally for years. Now they consider me a regular. Ha! Huh. Alright. I think we're done here now. Although, let's see. Just take me down to the first floor. I think one of these people were selling Pokeballs here. I can even get Ultra Balls here if I wanted to, but I think that may be a little mush for now, so I'll just focus on Great Balls for now. I'll grab another 12 of these. I'll have one Ultra Ball on standby just in case. I can get the Max Repels if I want to, but I burned through all my cash, so I think that's all I can do for now. Alright, so now, the next port of call would be Veilstone City, or Pastoria City, I should say. I'm in Veilstone right now. But since I have Fly, I can probably check a few other places here. So Pastoria City is right down here. Looks like I could take this route down. We'll pass through Verity Lakefront, or Valor Lakefront. Big there in the Sunny Shore City, which I think is the home of the final gym. But you know, I can fly now, so I think I'm gonna jet back a few. So, and Staraptor is gonna come and take me there. Now, I think there was some place here that did fossil studies. I think it's in the museum. Maybe I can get Cranidos here. Hello, hello, how are you? I study Pokemon fossils, me, right here and now. You have a fossil for me, yes? Shall I turn into a Pokemon? Sure, I got a skull fossil. Okay. You leave and now come back. I will come back. You have Pokemon for me. Hello, I study Pokemon fossils. You were gone too long. You kept us waiting. Unacceptable. I literally just went in and out the door. This is your Kratos. You be good to it, okay? So now I have a straight up rock type. This was the same Pokemon that Roark used against me in the Ouroboros gym battle. The Headbutt Pokemon. It lived in jungles around 100 million years ago. Its skull is as hard as iron. Well, let's have a look at its stats. I'm curious to see what it's going to bring to the table here. Okay, it's level 1. So I'm literally starting from scratch with this guy. So let me go ahead and pull up my little EV calculator here. I'm dealing with Kratos. It is of an impish nature, which means it's times 1.1 in defense below and special attack, which I think is fine. They are mischievous. Starting you at level 1. Okay, so you got 12 HP, 7 attack, 6 defense, 4 special attack, 5 special defense, 6 speed. Has Mold Breaker as its ability. And, it's got a very solid defense, and I think kind of a middle-of-the-road everything else. Although it's a little early to determine what's going to be work best for this guy. Maybe I'll pop this guy in the daycare for a little while to see what he does. So I'll send him to a box for now, though. Alright, so now let me look at that town map again here. Forget where it was. Was it in Hardhome City? Yeah, I'm gonna head back to Hardhome actually now. Because I actually know of a place here that we actually neglected to stop by last time. Amity Square. Go out and stroll with your Pokemon. My Pikachu seems to like to be out of his Pokeball for a walk outside. I can tell because his cheeks are twitching like crazy. In Amity Square, you may go for a stroll with a cute Pokemon. Well, do I have any cute Pokemon? In Amity Square, you can go for a stroll with a cute Pokemon. Which Pokemon would you like to take a stroll together with? The only one I can is Monferno, so please do enjoy your time with Monferno, just the two of you. So I think actually you can take as many as you want, just as long as they're considered cute. Wonder if anything's around here. I come here with my Happiny every single day. Can let it run for you without any worries at all. Cute little houses up there. I see an item. TM45 Attract. Make your Pokemon or your opponent fall in love with your Pokemon. And may possibly keep them from attacking. Hello, you may cook berries and turn them into poppins. Okay. Let's give it a shot here. Let's try some of these Aspear berries, a Bluckberry, and a Raspberry. I have no clue how this is going to turn out, but maybe Monferno will help out. I want to get as close to the edge as possible, but not overflow it. I think I got it. I'm gonna slow down a bit. Try not to go too fast here. think that's probably my best effort. We got ourselves a foul poffin, but I didn't burn it. I didn't overflow it. Ugh. Yeah, I don't think I'd be cooking poffins for a while now. Anything up here? In any square, you can use the right stick to move the camera around and view your walking part or Pokemon as much as you like. You can also reset the camera to its original state by pressing and holding down the right stick. Huh, so you can. Those are ruins from a time long, long ago. Oh, I found an amulet coin in there. Have a Pokemon hold this, and any money you get will be doubled. Alright, I need you to get out of my way, Monferno. You kind of have me trapped in here. There's another item up here. Ooh, a spooky plate. Three beings were born to bind time and space. So I think this is like, what, my fourth, thing there? My fourth plate? Alright. I don't see anything else here. I can't bring out the Pokedex at all. I guess this is where we leave. Alright, thank you very much. Oh, looks like the Pokemon that was taking a stroll wants to go out. Only special trainers can make their Pokemon feel that way. I'm pretty sure your Pokemon will be delighted if you let them out of your Pokeballs outside the square, too. Oh? Can I do that now? Will Monferno accompany me outside the Pokeball now? Because that would be awesome. Huh. He is out. Well, that is cool. So, yeah. So I guess Monferno's gonna stick around with me for a while. Excellent. Okay. Was there anything else I need to do? You know what? I think I'm gonna go ahead now. All I could do with my other Pokemon as well? So I can. I'm just testing this out here. So now I can have any one of my Pokemon work with me here. That is awesome. So it's not just Monferno. But you know what? Since you are my team captain, I think I'll have you out. And I'm going to give... let's see. There's so many things here. I've got to start getting organized here. Let me give this to Luxio. So now, whenever Luxio's in a trainer battle, if it ends up getting in a fight we win, then we'll get double the money. Okay, I gotta think now. Let's head back. This is another way to get to your HM moves. Choose fly. And, yeah, I got drift on my controller here. Don't need to go to Jubilife. I think I want to go back to Celestion Town so I can drop off, Kranidos. I wanted to get some levels. And it'll just be Kranidos here. So I actually want to work with my Pokemon here. So I wonder if I can just grab Kranidos right from the box here. Yeah, I can. Okay. So Kranidos. And I don't think anybody else. Maybe Bidoof, just so I can get it for its evolution. Oh, but I need money. Alright, so I'm gonna have to make a little money first. Luckily, I think I got some spare items I can part with here, so. Except I need to find the Pokemart here. I'll get rid of a few of these Pokeballs, since I'm going to be transitioning to Great Balls soon. That should be enough. I think I'm just going to keep using Pokeballs until I run out, then I'll officially switch over to Great Balls. And also by doing this, I can better get an idea of how good my Kranidos is going to be once I get it a few more levels. But yeah, Bidoof and Kranidos. Because I don't know if I'm going to use Kranidos at any point in my journey. I just got to remember they're still here. Maybe I'll pick them up in an episode or two. Okay. So, let's see. So the next step is... Do I want to go this route, or... I got a decision I gotta make. I'm gonna head back to Hard Home for now. And then decide what route I want to take to Pestoria. And by the way, how's my egg doing? The egg will hatch soon. Hopefully soon, or rather than later. Alright, well anyway, I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here, and then next episode we'll decide the route we're going to take to Pastoria City. Until then, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.